right, welcome back, everybody. Technically, we didn't go because you're watching live. Those of you who are watching live, anyway.
I can't wear the hat.
I know.
Do you have any that's chat stuff up?
Yep.
I think so. That is fair enough. The role here, because... All right.
I can't even find where that's at in the book.
What, pipe?
No, it's disguise kit.
It might be in the DMG.
The disguise kit?
I mean, the rolls for it. Because I'm fairly certain with proficient tools, don't you just roll and add your proficiency modifier? Like with these tools?
I think so. Let me check and see if it's in here. Not in here.
I am 4'4". I am super short.
Technically speaking, there are...
We'll make you some stilts.
There are short Mind Flayers because of the way that Mind Flayers are, like, created or born.
I don't think they're that short.
Okay. For those of you that don't know, Cephalos can explain this, but I will. This is something your characters don't know, but you'll know as players here in a moment. According to Volo's Guide to Monsters, there are the little tadpole things, and they capture races. Elves, dwarves, gnomes, halflings, whatever. And the little tadpole thing crawls inside.
Okay, I didn't get that far in Volo's.
Eats the brain and grows up
transforms
the body into...
So it doesn't matter about my height.
Yeah. Height is not super important. Yeah. We're going to do a house rule here.
What for disguise kit?
This will have to...
I googled it. That's basically what it says. You kind of have to... It's
yeah.
Up to the DM.
This will be... Because you're, you know, using your hands to do all the makeup and stuff. This will be dexterity. And you are proficient with the disguise kit.
Yes.
So, and proficiency. So kind of like a skill check for disguise. Now, it's not a double proficiency thing or anything like that.
Yeah. Because
you didn't take expertise in disguise kit.
Yeah. Right. So.
Yeah, that's fair.
If someone's helping you, you will have advantage.
Okay. And there are three of us. Four.
And
now.
I agree.
Five disguise kits that you need to, disguises that you need to make.
Okay. And so I get advantage on all those. What's the number, or do I have a target that I'm trying to hit?
He knows.
Yes, you do.
And I don't know what it is.
And you do not know what it is.
I won't know what it is until after we've gotten there, will I?
That is a completely accurate statement.
All right.
Who are you starting with first?
Okay, I'm just going to go around the table.
There. Okay, so we're starting with him.
Nagri.
Roll high.
Or Evander.
Okay.
Nagri or Evander.
Do Nagri first. He's all right. Not here.
Nagri first. Yeah. Okay, so I get advantage. It is nice that I have a +5 dex.
And a +4
yeah.
or 5 proficiency bonus?
Yeah, so it's +10.
Very nice.
Plus you can take a 10 on skill checks.
Hmm?
You can take a 10 on skill... No, you can't. You're not that high level rogue.
Nope.
I tried.
Alright. 4. Well, that's 15.
15 for Nagri.
Out of the way.
Five. With advantage.
5 twice.
Got it. Okay. Well, and then it's Evander.
That one's going to be good. Yeah, it's 27.
27. Nice.
I am a mind player.
Next is Imsh.
You have started to develop psychs. Nope, it is.
We're
going around the table.
They're we're
invisible.
Going to go invisible.
You're
going to
go invisible.
Once we see what happens.
Awesome. How long does that last? A minute?
I think it's...
Invisibility?
I'll be right back to you.
Okay, cool.
24.
Who...
Concentration an hour.
Okay, great. Who is next?
You.
Terrell?
That was Imsh, I think.
No, that wasn't...
No.
Okay.
Imsh going
that was,
invisible.
That was the third one.
So then we're doing...
I don't care what...
We're doing Terrell.
I don't care who. I'm just telling you the order.
24.
Yeah, so I've gone 15, 27, 24.
Got it. Okay. Next will be Ulfgar. It's just going around the table.
Yep. That one is going to be a 19.
Okay.
And then you.
Sorry.
Thanks, bro.
It was a nine.
You're the one helping him. You'll be assisting.
And then sigh.
Let's see if I have anything to help with this. Damage. AC.
A
29. Your skill check.
29.
Of course.
I am 19.
At least you're not angry.
I have cardboard on my face.
Hey, 19 is not bad.
That's not bad.
Well, we don't know what the point. The
disguise kit at this point is totally used up.
Okay.
So
I have one.
I have the relevant scores. Is there anything else you want to do to prepare before you enter the hive?
I think I might do an augury again.
Okay.
Whichever one gives me a better look at. How close are we to the hive?
Man.
You are...
This would have been the perfect time to have bardic inspiration.
It's too late now.
I think you're all right.
Too late now, my friend.
I think you're all right.
All right.
Hold on, I need to figure out which one I need to do here.
I'm alright.
Oh, I'm going to do augury because I didn't take the spell today.
This guy's under 20.
I didn't take animation today.
Doesn't count.
Okay.
How close are we to the hive?
You are about... You're kind of in a nook getting all this prepared.
Yeah, see, I can't.
You're about...
The within the next 30 minutes.
Oh, definitely, yeah. You're about 10 minutes away from entering the outskirts of the hive.
Alright, I'm going to do an augury. So, let me see here. Take out my dragon dunkle dice.
Okay.
I'm just gonna mime this because it doesn't really matter what I roll.
You shouldn't grab a bunch.
Yep.
Okay.
And cast the bones.
Alright. And what is your question?
If we walk into this shit show wearing these disguises, are we likely to make it to the Elder Brain without losing hit points, taking damage.
Yeah, you haven't rolled meta knowledge high enough yet to know about hit points.
Aw, oh, dude, you got a 2.
All right. Is it likely that you'll make it to the Elder Brain without taking?
Do you think?
Because I'm pretty sure we'll wind up there one way or the other, but one way we're going to be injured.
Right. Right.
Basically, is it? Are we going to get noticed?
The odds.
Forever.
It's like a vague answer.
Great.
No, like, what does it say?
Let's see.
Maybe.
Oh.
That would be the answer.
Magic game ball. What is the answer?
Maybe.
Try again later.
Try again later.
You try so try it again immediately. Try again later.
Dang it, how did it know?
How does it know?
Okay, got it. You receive an omen from an otherworldly entity about the result of a specific course of action that you plan to take within the next 30 minutes. Alright. Since you are kind of tied in and you're sort of speaking to the Stone Mother.
I'm sitting on stone right now, so that helps.
Yes. The omen that you get is that kind of walking as you begin or like kind of where you are off to the side, you see a vein of Mithril.
I'm gonna interpret that as a good thing.
It's not like a huge vein, but yeah.
So there's a good chance. Yeah,
like your eyes are drawn to it after you cast the spell.
It's like, I think we've got a good chance of getting to the Elder Brain without hurting ourselves.
Oh,
plus there's some Mithril over here if we want it.
Yes. This is outside of the range of the Kirill mine, so it's all yours.
Sweet, I'm gonna go take that.
Okay.
Anyone level 40?
I'm gonna get spiritual
weapon
and make
level 40 mining.
Fantastic. Okay.
I've got a really big portable hole.
Got an
addy. Throw it all into.
Open
it. Excellent.
I'm trying. We're gonna be rich.
You play it?
Once a week.
So.
alive. We can make it out of this alive.
Percentile roll.
And yes, I know this may be one of those circumstances that the spell did not take into account.
It certainly is.
I'm guessing that's what I'm rolling for at this point.
Well, not exactly.
81.
That's good. 81 is very good. So you get from it. Takes a little bit of time to get it all out. But you eventually get, we will say, 20 pounds of mithril.
Well, that's good. That's not bad.
That's really good.
Considering mithril is really lightweight.
It takes you about 30-ish minutes to get it out.
We should have taken a long rest because I'm kind of fucked on spells now.
Let me tell you, it's loud. Thank you for that.
You're welcome.
Oh.
Dang
it, I keep thinking of ideas afterward.
I was using a spiritual weapon, though, so how could it have been loud? I wasn't using
it's
my
breaking
hammer.
The stone.
I mean, so stone's falling. We're in the Underdark. Stones fall all the time.
Yeah. Tink,
there's
tink,
no tinking.
Tink.
There's no tinking.
Then how are you getting the mithril out?
It's a weapon made of light.
Uh-huh. You're not talking your way out of this,
this
one, bro.
Damn it! Play music.
Why did I not pass without trace? It also muffles sound.
Okay.
And
now.
So these disguises.
You might want to go invisible.
What
just
does,
real quick, bro?
I know, but can I look at Nagri and like?
We have been hurt.
Invisible, me and Ish.
He says.
Put this disguise on now.
Well, no, you're all disguised up already.
I'm gonna jump in that portal hole. You're gonna leave that open.
Okay, then you need to start going now.
Right. Yes. Hey, you can just form up a staircase with all your mithril.
And they are like you have the longer tentacles. Because if you just had the regular kind of tentacles, they would be very suspicious because you're not connected to the hive.
So we look like Illithrids.
Yeah.
Like a group of Illithrids walking into oh shit. That's not a good thing.
No. Well, Ruth's the heart does.
Take you seriously when you talk.
I love it.
Can
it's
you,
great.
Can
you're
you
all must speak like this.
Yeah, it's,
no,
it's
you're
a group.
Shitting me.
It's like a 30-foot
this is how we talk.
Oh my god.
Hey.
Yeah.
Evander.
This is how
we
talk.
We have to talk like that.
You cannot use your normal voice, okay?
It's very nice.
I'm
just
really trying to make the Scottish accent sound good with that.
He gave me a good idea. I'm going to go ahead and cast Pass Without Trace around our group.
Okay.
Now. So that way...
How long does that last?
10 minutes, I believe.
So that'll get you to the gate. To the doorway.
Okay.
Kind of
you roll me a stealth check with disadvantage?
No. Are you trying to stealth in? Because you can try that.
No, I'm not trying to stealth. I'm trying to.
I mean, it's feasible.
Yeah.
For you.
I'm essentially trying to be able to
not draw attention to us.
Yeah.
Okay. How long is it left?
Just go through, but casually.
Like Assassin's Creed, just
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hide.
Don't pay this to me.
But not the actual D&D hide.
And then it's really funny, like when it glitches, because you like.
Oh. Ow.
Up to an hour. Hilarious. Okay, cool. That works out pretty well. Very good. All right.
Good planning.
You can, if you wish, try to stealth in. If you want to just kind of walk in all confident-like.
Or invisible.
It really, I don't want us to necessarily...
You're moving.
I mean, I'm not trying to take over everything,
yep.
But, not necessarily, go shadow to shadow and, try to avoid all sight, but, try to go
business
through.
Business as usual.
Yeah, business as usual. Pretty much like people
not
are like as we're walking
through,
people are not going to notice.
Illiterate.
Yeah.
You are confident. You will walk in.
And pass without trace, you said muffled sound, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, veils and shadows and silence. A veil of shadows and silence radiates from you, masking you and your companions from detection.
Okay.
For the duration.
Each creature within 30 feet of me, including you, has a +10 bonus to dexterity stealth checks.
That's good. That'll be good for them trying to stealth in.
Also, and can't be trapped, except by magical means.
Good.
Good.
Good. Good. Good.
All right. So, you get... You get to the outskirts of the hive.
Can we see inside of it?
Got my hands in my cloak like a monk or something.
Right. I mean, like, they have normal hands.
I figured their skin was, like, bluish.
There is, but you have a disguise kit.
Not
We've accommodated.
You have accommodated.
I got a 19 on my disguise, so.
That's not bad.
Are you an angry? Angry's the one who's screwed. He's the dragon I had to try.
The translucence, it was a little bit tricky. In fact, impossible to get with makeup, but you got it really close. Like, as close as you can.
Like, basically, instead of trying to make it translucent, trying to make it look like you could see, make it look like there's a bone that you can kind of, like, see.
Yeah. That kind of thing.
That's what I did on mine that I got a 29 on.
Fuck you.
You said like cave-like boss, so just kind of just make a little light action.
Do. Yeah, that's funny.
So Nagger's like, well, you're a dragon. I don't know how to make you look like you're not a dragon.
Let's just throw these tentacles on your face, a robe on you, you're good.
Just don't say I'm a dragon.
Guys, I'm a dragon.
Oh my gosh, this is gonna go.
Please call the Elder Brain a bitch.
So
yeah, thank God some ammo play.
All right.
Well,
there are.
Let's do this.
Sort of guards, just more mind flayers, that are there. There are two kind of side by side, in front, or off to either side of the entryway. When they see you, they kind of look confused because they can only sense Cephalos. They kind of, you all approach.
Stone of Salve!
Are you trying to intimidate?
I probably shouldn't. I really probably shouldn't.
Give me.
I can.
Give me an intimidation check.
Oh, that's good. That is a 22.
22.
I have proficiency in intimidation. I didn't realize that.
Okay. I kind of move up to question, and then when you say that, they kind of their eyes widen a little bit. And they kind of like cower back and let you pass.
Good. Good.
Yep, I rolled low for the insight.
One down, all right, like 30 to go.
So I just need to keep shouting, stand aside.
As soon as we all get in. Maybe we should let Sephiroth do some more of the talking.
Sephiroth?
We're following.
I really hope he doesn't turn out to be Sephiroth. That would be sad.
Seth pulls that mess of.
That's hilarious.
Bob, you want to. We should follow behind, I guess.
Yeah, we'll just follow.
Alright, so...
Please try not to bump into people.
Yeah, that's the plan. We're
gonna get in. I first want to look and see if there is, like, the quickest... Like, if there's just, like, a very quick way to get to the Elder Brain. Can I see it? What's the quickest way to it? Etc. Just...
To see?
Yeah. Like, just if like, maybe there's a straight-ass...
Yeah, like, Cephalos knows the way. He's been there. He's from the hive.
Okay.
He knows where to go.
It was a really good idea to ask him to come along.
Yes, it was. I agree with that. Now,
I have good plans.
You notice, okay, you notice several things.
Thank God the bear and the drunk guy are
invisible. Oh, yeah, that's a good thing.
As you enter the tunnel. It's 5 foot. It's a very, it's a narrow tunnel. And it is kind of elliptical or oval shaped, if you will. You kind of approach this. It looks like the easiest way for me to explain it is, you know the doors in Jabu Jabu's belly and Ocarina of Time?
No?
Yeah.
Okay. It's like a it's a fleshy looking
portal
covering. Cephalos is leading, of course. And you see his eyes glow a little bit and the fleshy thing.
I think kind of like a
opens
really,
up.
Like a clenched up butthole that just opens.
Thanks.
Okay.
Yeah, kind of. It's gross. It's pretty gross.
Does it smell like that too?
No.
Okay.
No. It is. It does have a strange smell in here. You see a sort of. You see a guard room when the portal opens. And within. There are, where is that? I'm gonna need more books.
Hey, buddy.
Hand me a couple of those index cards, please.
Yep.
Doesn't matter if there's anything written on them. I'm just, I need bookmarks for marking my pages.
Yep.
The pages.
We really should have long rested. I'm gonna die.
Standing in the guard room as initial.
Oh, good.
Oh, wait.
Get the hell out of there, real quick.
Over here, yes.
I could have used stone shape to get that natural, not worried them.
Yeah.
Hindsight.
Yep. Alright.
Hindsight's always.
In the guard room, you see. Because it's about a 30 foot by 30 foot spherical room. And on either side of another one of the little creepy fleshy portals, you see hook horrors. Which are these large bird bug things. They have beaks and like massive claws. I'll show
you
a picture.
They basically look like they're made of stone.
These right here.
Oh, no, they look like birds.
They're friendly. Yeah.
They
okay, Hagrid.
Are what? Yeah.
Clacker.
Yep.
Poor Clacker.
Clacker.
It's a sad.
Well.
From the first three.
Dread spoke.
Yeah. So doesn't he die in the acid pit?
No.
Some like
Zachnophane.
Right.
Like they make it. Just passed.
Can't wait for the next book.
They make it just passed.
Cannot wait. All right. So you didn't long rest, and we'll see how that pans out. You get. They don't even like care, because they're all mind slaves of the hive, and they're just there in the event that the place needs to be defended. So, they kind of stand aside. Cephalos opens the portal again. And you go in. And this is actually a, it's still 5 foot. Still narrow. It's a little slick and, steep. It's fairly steep. Cephalos actually, at this point, will, like, levitate and start to float down the thing. Everyone that's walking down, I need to make dexterity. Wait, first of all, what's the walking order? Yeah.
I'll go out first.
I'll go first.
That would be
the next guys.
Sure.
Okay.
Cool. If I'm first, everyone has to be within 30 feet of me. Otherwise,
be in the middle.
I'll say otherwise they're out of my
B.
This this isn't. I don't know if this is stealth or.
There they are. It's like, where's my. Where's my other thingy? I mean,
that's. How many people do we have them on?
Eight.
Go first, I guess, because we don't want
to. You'll have to be in the center to continually.
Take them all.
Are we in a single file?
That's probably a good plan.
It's yeah. It's a 5 foot.
Okay, then I'm not. I'm not in front. Then I'm probably gonna be like a third or fourth.
Can I use an athletics check instead?
I. Yeah.
Woo!
I will allow it, and I'll explain why. You got like reach, so you can like. Hold yourself from slipping down.
Cool.
All right, walking order. Cephaloscus first.
Pretty sure. Hold on. What is that? What was that stone? Who has that stone? The teleportation stone. To get out of here.
Eli's character.
Terrell has it.
And that allows how many characters? To
I believe it is eight.
Eight. Okay.
Well,
is it instantaneous or is it like casting time?
It's instantaneous.
Okay.
And we'll take
so
you.
Because I forgot to pick my 7th level spell today.
Okay, and it will
Team
take you
room.
To, as I recall correctly,
sort of spinning.
It and should take you to
away.
The guild hall.
Yeah.
Because it was given to you by Kagan.
Yeah.
Yep.
It takes.
So yeah, it takes you. It takes you to Sartek City.
But
so
it'd be real dang inconvenient to have to come all the way back here.
Yeah.
So we gotta get.
So
what
that's
we
a last resort.
Yeah.
So.
Order is Cephalosk first.
And M/Rainer.
M/ Eisenschmidt. Because we're not going to take.
All right.
Out.
Now you.
Okay.
This is a narrow fit because. Well, I say that. It's not. Never mind. You're good because the hook horrors have to be able to like. They managed to get through that somehow. So.
The bear's not 5 feet across.
Yeah.
Either,
so. You. What did you roll?
We got a
20.
Nat,
30.
Okay.
Nat 20.
Good on that.
Yeah.
Who is after that?
Yeah.
I'll be after that.
That's amazing.
Okay.
Alright.
Keep good the healer job. On the back, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
So we've made it down.
What is your dexterity saving throw?
Five.
I will allow either dexterity saving throw, acrobatic, something like that. Something to help you stay up. Even athletics. Because this is narrow enough that you can, like, brace yourself against the walls.
I use any of those? All
yeah.
Five. So.
Okay. 19 is good.
That's the best dex roll I've ever had.
And I can, on saving throws, I can re-roll, and I have to go to the second one no matter what. And I'm going to use that, at least one of them right
luck?
Now. No, it's,
downable.
Yeah. I'm glad I did. It's a good plan. 16.
Good. Who's after Evander? That
I
would
can,
probably be Sai.
Yeah, I'll go after. Because as
okay.
long as I'm like.
You're,
in the middle.
That would be in the
yeah.
middle.
Yeah, that's middle.
So you.
Out of 25.
25 is. friggin'.
Acrobatics. Great.
Okay. Terrell will probably go after you. And he got. It's a natural 18 and stuff, so he's good.
I'm at the back.
Skip the
last.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Who are we missing?
Nagri.
Nagri.
Bob.
Oh,
Nagri.
Shit.
Nagri and then.
But we'll do athletics with Nagri because that's the best one I got. Come on.
And by the way, as you're going, he is like Cephalosk is telling you kind of what's going on.
21.
Like as far as
Black
where score. They're headed. And when it's good. We're going next to the common room. Yes.
The Gryffindor kind of room?
No.
Sir!
What is Gryffindor?
We're running out of this bomb.
Doors?
You've not rolled high enough meta knowledge yet.
Yeah.
There was a story I heard once.
Got a galaxy far, far.
You get to the end of the walkway, and the portal opens up, because he does that. And in here... The common room, you notice... Okay, so it serves as a gathering spot for the thralls. And you see all kinds of different stuff in here. You see some gnomes. You see a few dwarves.
Do I recognize anybody?
Both normal, like sort of regular dwarves and Duergar.
Actually, that's a good point.
Obviously, prisoners under control.
Give me a
history
check.
History?
Or just
a drow named Alexandros.
I'd say perception.
Perceptions. I mean, you can see everything in there.
Okay.
But do you know them? Is a different. It's a whole different thing. Give me a d20, and add your intelligence.
That's shit. 7.
Yeah, we don't know anyone.
Oh, that's good.
Does anyone want to see if they know any of these people?
Sure.
I would say that the odds of it are very low, but you never know.
All right, I'll roll
for it. History. I'm invisible.
And what are we doing? Intelligence.
I will take history or just a regular intelligence check.
Well, those are both zero.
Yep. Well, you'll take history.
So I rolled a 9.
Yeah. Nope.
I got a 19 with history.
Okay.
15.
Yep. 1 and a 16.
Oh,
so now you got a 16.
All right. And what did you get?
It was
everybody
16.
Get
I've actually unlearned not from things after that.
Yours is 19.
I forgot things.
Let's see. Who would you know?
His brother.
No, his brother.
That would bring concentration.
He's super dead.
His brother's dead. Okay.
My baby,
Schmitty. This is a baby there.
How did Schmitty get here?
Oh, okay. Hang on.
We built this Schmitty.
Alright. You see.
Zero.
There are some dark elves or death elves that are down here. One of them looks incredibly familiar to you.
Joe Mama.
Throw her from that train.
Her name is.
Yes.
Replacement! Her name's Replacement!
Her name is Replacement. Wow, no, her name is not.
Replacement. Mint.
Well, there it is.
Her name is Side Bitch.
Side Woo. Beat you.
Really, guys? Really? Come on now.
I've had way too much caffeine tonight.
I just knew her as I might see you later, so.
I might see you
I might have. I might have see you later.
I promise I'll get you a biscuit in the morning.
You actually know her as what her name to be? Damn it!
You get
24
hours.
I need to get Papuka.
You get to get
nope.
If you want.
Not that.
That's
here we go. This will work.
Me and the wife Saturday morning. Tutors in cartoons.
It is
usually either.
Okay. That'll work.
Anyway, it's Spider-Man or X-Men Evolution.
Nice.
One of the two is what we usually do.
Watch the original X-Men cartoon.
Well, they have Evolution all on Hulu.
And on Netflix.
Nope, we're just going to do it. Thea.
Thea?
T-H-I-A.
Is her last name Queen?
No.
Does she go by Speedy?
No. You recognize her as Aaron's twin sister.
Oh shit!
How convenient.
you have only heard of her. You had never seen her because she went missing
a long time ago. I knew that she existed.
Yeah, because you spent a lot of time with Aaron, of course, and you've had discussions and things. You do know that she had a twin sister. Has, I guess, in this case, because the twin sister's still alive. Who went missing about 10 years ago.
Cool.
Hey, she hasn't been turned into a mind flayer, so that's good.
Yeah. Yeah.
As far as we know, there could be a tadpole in her head.
You actually see... Now, there's not just thralls in here. There's actually, there's one mind flayer who is getting a, like, he or it, whatever, you can't really tell sexes with mind flayers. It is, getting a, like, it's getting its head massaged by Thea. She has very dexterous
fingers. Oh, I know. I imagine. It's anything like Aaron. I basically whisper to him, damn, they got some really good genes.
The,
Do y'all have anybody?
Do you have
deception?
A third sister by chance?
The mind?
Was there a triplet?
Hmm.
<Awesome. laughs>
Perception check is +6. Okay, got it. You all walk in, and the mind flayer looks at you all like it's whatever. It's surprised to see more than one Ulitharid, but there is some like minor glows, like flashes of lights for their eyes. And they are kind of communicating telepathically with Cephalosk.
Oh, that's good. He can have a conversation without us hearing it. That's great.
Yeah.
Well, he doesn't and like these guys, so.
It seems to stop really
this
focusing on you guys until you get most of you in there. And you notice it kind of turn its head a little bit when Nagri walks in.
God damn it, what did Nagri get?
16.
I turn to Cephalos and say, tell them who's wanted at the door. Just fucking do it. Order them up there. Get them the fuck out of this room, dude.
Get them out of this room, dude. That's awesome. I love that. Okay. Well.
I have no deception skill whatsoever, so please do this.
Lutherid is
doing
like two. That's fine. It was told to be called out. Let me get that notated here. He has no deception skill, but he has high charisma, so that's fun. Let's see. They rolled the same. Out. Insight is +6. It's not really, it's just giving it a good command. Alright. He communicates telepathically more with the mind flayer there. And the mind flayer kind of gives him a curious stare, but he gets up and maneuvers back through that portal that you all came in from.
We can take it with us too.
Well,
we've got 17.
Yeah. He
just fucked up.
He continues down across the room to another of the doors. It opens. You kind of head through a smaller hallway into a side chamber, and then there's another steep drop on, like, off to another door on the right. A steep drop. It's kind of very narrow, so even if you happen to fall, I won't make you roll for this one, it's not a big deal. And you get into what is called the transformation chamber. Lining the walls are these cells, like pods, if you will. They are various creatures. that you can tell from their state, both, well, mostly physically, that they have been undergoing massive experimentation.
They're happy to be here.
Yeah. There's a semi-spherical stone on a dais on, like, kind of in the center of this room that has all these little, like, etches and very finite markings on it. It's not a discernible language that you all know, but it seems to be some kind of notational system. You think. You don't really know.
I'm guessing deep speech. But I don't know that language.
Sevalosk kind of moves up to it, and his tentacles kind of begin moving around the stone as if reading it.
What's it says?
He ignores you. he kind of nods. And then you move forward to another door. Opens up. There's about a 10-foot pathway again. Still kind of slimy. Gross. Smells a bit like... Well...
Formaldehyde?
It's apt. No. You know what Gak smells like?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It smells kind of like Gak. Gak was a... This really, it's really gross. It smells... It's not, like, nauseatingly bad, but it's not... It's just unpleasant. It probably would have a faint formaldehyde-ish smell, too.
I'm not gonna get this place off my boots or out of my nose for months.
Mm-hmm. Now... When the portal on the other side of this little 10-foot walkway opens up, it's into a fairly sizable chamber. In the center of this chamber lies a pool, if you will, that is covered in this glass, what you assume to be glass.
I need...
How much time do we have? I need to prepare this.
Just want to go ahead and end this one?
Yeah, go ahead and end this one. We will be right back, folks.
So if you want to prepare, I'm going to
take a break.
Yeah, you guys can take a break. I got to do a little prep work.